I'm Dr. Tanveer Ahmed. This is practical number one of course AN201, Principles of Animal Nutrition. Though this is not a sort of practical to perform, rather these are some of the lab safety rules which we have to follow while working in the animal nutrition laboratory. So what is safety? Safety is simple as ABC. ABC mean always be careful. So whenever you are in a lab, you have to follow all the safety rules. The objective is to protect yourself and to protect the others working in the laboratory. So every laboratory in the department, they have their safety rule chart. So you have to follow those while working in a laboratory or in any other working place, not only in the laboratory, but when we are in a laboratory, we deal with a lot of harmful substances, hazardous material. We are going to work some time during the off hours. So that's why safety is more important. So when we talk about safety, safety is a personal activity. So it's a personal activity, but it's a shared responsibility. Because my mistake may not harm me, but it might harm some other in the laboratory, or it might destroy the experiment of other working in the laboratory. So everyone working in the laboratory should recognize the possible hazards that one may face while doing work. First thing first, it means when we are in a lab, we must wear personal protective equipment. These personal protective equipment are required for the safety of the personnel working in the laboratory. The appropriate PPE for all the chemicals being worked within the lab must be worn or used. They include eye protection PPEs like glasses, goggles, safety shield. Safety shields are particularly required when one is working with isotopes, lab coat, no open toe shoes. Particularly in case of girls, they wear open toe shoes, so they should not be worn while working in the laboratory. Then we should go for using the gloves. They are required all the time in the laboratory work. So when we are using these PPEs, we must check with the manufacturer or supplier to ensure that they have been tested for all the chemicals being used in the laboratory. Then next come the labeling of the stuff. So all hazardous product, including waste, they must be clearly identified through proper labeling. So at least when we are putting through the trash or in the waste bin, either they are the chemicals, they are the leftover material, so at least the percent composition should be mentioned while throwing into the waste bin. Label quality, it must be ensured that they should not be of a very poor quality, or it should be torn out. So appropriate and in long-term storage labels, they are required. Then comes the labeling of reagents and chemicals. All the chemicals or reagents, or even the prepared solutions, they should be kept in a properly labeled bottles on the shelves. The reason being, sometimes we left the stuff as such, like if we left N/10 sulfuric acid or ICL solution without labeling the flask, no one knows what is inside the flask, either it is a water or distilled water or it is an acid. So everything should be properly labeled, and they should be kept in a systematic way so that it could be easy for everyone to identify them and to get that stuff. So while working in the laboratory, always take care of the area where you are working. So all the personnel using the lab facilities, they are required to read entirely all assigned laboratory safety material and signs and affirmation that it has been read, and the sign and affirmation that it has been read. So keep in mind, in our laboratory, sometimes we do not have such type of system, but at least it should be there so that the safety and precautionary measure, they should be read and then signed by the person who is going to work in the laboratory. So before beginning any lab activity, always receive instruction from the laboratory in charge as staff regarding location and proper use of the safety equipment. They are very much important because sometimes there is a fire hazard, and at that time we do not get the stuff to get rid of that fire, or sometimes there are a lot of fumes in the animal nutrition laboratory. So how to protect yourself, and where are some instruments that are available, or such safety material as available when you inhale the fumes or you got some injury. So that's why always you know the location of all those safety equipments. The next one is clean and neat work area. That is required to avoid the risk of damage, because when you put certain chemicals which are hazardous, and there are some splashes of that material, but you are not aware, and you just left the area as such, so other person might get that hazardous material. It might cause burning of the skin or either the lab coat of the individual. So always clean and neat work area to avoid the risk of damage. Neatness also reduces the fire hazards. Sometimes certain chemicals, they like ether, that might cause this fire hazard. So whenever you are leaving the area, you are leaving the lab, so make it sure that you have clean all the stuff over there. Fooling around in the laboratory, sometimes we may start fooling in the laboratory, but that may cause hazard, or to avoid such hazards, it is better to be a normal person rather than doing fooling in the lab. Laboratory should have an efficient ventilation and exhaust system, because when there are fumes, particularly the acid fumes during wet digestion, protein digestion, we are using sulfuric acid or sometimes hydrochloric acid for acid insoluble ash determination or solubilization of some other stuff. So in that case, we need a proper ventilation system so that fumes, they will not accumulate in the area. They should be properly exhausted out from the room. So in case of equipment, or while you are going to start your experiment, to get demonstration of the use of any equipment, either from the instructor or from the lab attendant, and ask for proper instruction if you have any doubt about the procedure of the experiment. So read and follow instruction manual for the safe use and maintenance of the equipment. This is very much important, because sometimes we may cause damage to the equipment, even with our very little and poor handling of the stuff of that equipment. So because these equipment, they are the costly equipment, not only in nutrition lab but in other labs. So always be good and read and follow the instruction manual for the safe use of and for the maintenance of the equipment. Do not use extension cord. Sometimes it might happen the power plug is not working, and we may go for using the extension cord, but it might cause some fire hazard due to electric short circuiting, and sometime due to just little disturbance at the extension cord, it might cause damage to the lab equipment, which are too much costly. Be aware of the potential hazard involved in any procedure, like I have talked about the fumes during digestion, at the time of protein determination, and at the time of mineral determination, there is also production of fumes when we do wet digestion. So all such type of potential hazard, they must be known to the person. The most important thing, sometimes we are hungry and we go for eating or drinking in the lab. So food or drink, they must not be allowed in the lab, and they're not to be consumed in the lab.
The reason being, sometimes there is material there, or particularly when we are doing experiment by using some food or feed stuff, or their contamination might can be transferred. So to avoid health hazard to the person who is consuming that food and drink, so it is not advisable to go to an area where there are chemicals and we start eating. So food or drink, they are not allowed in the lab. So the next, we should store our food items only in the fridge which is meant for food. So those fridges which are meant for food items, they should be used for storing food, because in the laboratory we have the refrigerator, we have deep freezer. They are meant for chemical storage, they are meant for sample storage. So they are not they should not be used for storing regular food items, because our food might be contaminated and we may got some sickness. Then never dispose of pop cans, food wrappers, or any evidence of food consumption in the lab and lab garbage. So because they might attract the insect, or sometime they might contaminate the stuff within the laboratory, particularly when we are doing with some microbiological experiments or food microbiology experiments. Drinking water bottles, sometimes they are brought by the student while they are coming to the laboratory during the practical class, so they should not be used for drinking purpose, and they should not be put on the lab bench or lab desk. They should be kept within the bags of the students. Smoking, not allowed in the lab in the university premises, so it is totally prohibited, not allowed at
while working in a laboratory. When someone is alone, he must inform his supervisor or other laboratory staff residing in the near vicinity of that lab, so that in case of any hazard, he or she may be taken care of. So whenever you are working during off day or late night, always follow this principle. The other thing is, do not carry out potentially hazardous experiment if you are ill alone. The reason being, when you conduct such experiment alone, in case of any hazard, no one can take care of you. So be careful while working alone in the laboratory.
Unattended experiments. Do not leave your experiment unattended, particularly when you are doing crude fiber and DFA, DF analysis, or sometimes ether extraction. There is a formation of fumes, or sometimes the material when we are boiling in the beakers, they might get out of the beakers and they might cause electric or fire hazard. So do not leave your experiment unattended. You must be there, or your supporting student must be there to avoid any hazard. So before an experiment is left unattended, take precautions to prevent the spills, flood, or fire in case of mechanical power or water failure. This is the most important thing, because sometimes due to our minor negligence, many large accident may occur. Here are the examples of some analysis that we that when we are doing on manual basis or single sample basis, they require the presence of the person who is doing the experiment. So when we are working with the animal, particularly we have to test the feed sample by using or by feeding to the animal. We also use the lab animal for testing the feed quality. We also use poultry, birds, large animals. So in any case, we must be very much careful, and we must know about the transmission of diseases from animal to the human. So when we are working with the animal, we are exposed to zoonotic diseases. So in that case, we must be careful, and we must know about those diseases, and we must follow all precautionary measures while doing those experiments. So generally, more similar a species is to man, the greater is the risk of acquiring a severe zoonotic disease. The more dissimilar, the more likely allergies will develop. So always be careful while working with the animal. So these are the things which are strictly not allowed. Unauthorized assistance with the work, the persons who are unauthorized or who are not allowed, like the family members, friends, which are not the bona fide university employed, and they do not know about your experiment, or they do not have idea about the safety protocol, they should not be given access to the laboratory. So unauthorized assistant with the work is not allowed in any laboratory of this department. Children, they are not allowed in the restricted area or the labs. The reason being, the children sometimes may create the problem, and there are number of issues that can arise due to the children, or problems might arise due to their activity, due to their unknowingness. So do not bring children into the lab. Even if you are making gold in the lab, do not bring your children into the lab, which human life is more important than any other thing. So do not bring those individuals, your family members, your friends, because they are not authorized to work with you. Similarly, children's they are not allowed on or off the main campus and labs during office hours, evening and weekend. Finally, some extra cautions. Here is the definition of harmful substances: that the substance which by its nature, application or presence create or could create a danger to the health and safety of any worker who is exposed to it. Be remember that water should never be added in the acid. Sometimes such mistakes might occur. So when you want to add mix water with the acid, so always add acid in the water. So acid is added in the water. Or always use large capacity flask. Suppose if you are going to prepare a solution of 1 liter, to at least use a double capacity flask, so to avoid any splashes or any spill. Mouth pipetting is not allowed, because we are used to go for mouth pipetting of different type of chemicals, but please do not go for mouth pipetting. So to do when start or finish your working, particularly analytical balance, they are very much sensitive. So when you are going to weigh the sample, first of all check the position of the balance. It should be clean and neat, its pen should be clean one, and then it should be on a flat surface, it should be on a level surface. So when you did your work, when you finish your work, then clean the pen and do not disturb the balance position, so that it should be remain okay for the next student. Every effort should be made to clean oven, desiccator and related equipment as soon as possible, so that other may use the facility. So everyone is responsible for properly washing his or her own glassware and returning it to the lab attendant or to the storage. So last but not least, fire extinguishing equipment. They should always be present in the laboratory so as to take care of the accidental firing. So these equipments, they are available on the floor but not in the lab. So you should know how to use them, because in case of any fire hazard, you can you could be able to get rid of the fire, or you can extinguish that fire in a little time. So thank you. The next practical will be on identification of feedstuff and their nutritional composition.